Okay. So first topic for today's discussion is on decision trees and utility theory. Okay. So what are decision trees and what are the components and why it is called a decision tree and what happens in the process shall be discussed in the coming slides. Okay. What is involved in decision, in making a good decision is certain aspects like the decision should be logical in nature. The whatever decision, okay, that is taken for completing a task should have some scientific and systematic approach, okay, and then decisions are taken. Okay, so this is not pertaining to any one subject or any one specific domain. Okay, so this is a very generic topic, and it can be applied for any subject. Okay, so decision decision theory is an analytic and systematic approach to study a decision. Okay, so a good decision is one that is based on logic, considers all available data and possible alternates, and the quantitative approach for measurement. Okay, so decision actually, normally this is asked in the in planning exercise or in policy making exercise. Okay, what is the first step that needs to be taken in a planning exercise or a policy exercise? Can anybody guess? What is the first step? Okay, let us put that question into building and the constructions as well. Okay, so what is the first step that needs to be taken when it comes to construction of a building? Okay, so yeah, so so to summarize, a good decision is one that is based on logic, considers all available data and publish possible alternatives, and a quantitative approach for measurement. Okay, there are two, three keywords that is mentioned here. Okay, one is on logic. Okay, and also the second aspect is on data and possibilities of alternates. Okay, so based on what data source we are making a decision. Okay, and what are the alternate means of doing the same exercise? Fine. And the third thing is whether the decision is based on a quantitative judgment or it is a qualitative judgment. Okay, so I hope we are able to understand what you mean by quantitative, and we have discussed this in the earlier classes, what is qualitative approach and what is quantitative approach. Okay, so if you see the theory, okay, since we are looking this decision making from the lens of statistics and statistical theory, okay, so there are certain things that is mentioned in the literatures. There are six steps in decision making, and we have to it is advised that we follow these systematic process, these systematic steps to arrive at decision. Okay, so what is the first step? The first step is to define the problem. Okay, so like we were saying, what is the objective of making the decision? The first step. Okay, so the second one, list the possible alternates. Okay, what are the other ways which we can do? Okay, any task is not one dimensional. Okay, so it can be achieved through other means as well, right? So how do you what are the alternate methods of achieving the same results? Okay, that is the second step. Identify the possible outcomes of the state of nature. Okay, what are the possible outcomes because of the decision that we may have made. Okay, what will be the whether it will be beneficial or it will be harmful? Okay, so or do we will we get profit or will we may end up in loss? Those kind of assumptions and estimations need to be worked out. Okay, list the payoff for each of the combination. For example, if we have worked out, let's say, two or three alternates, for all two or three alternates, we should work out what is the profit and loss, or what is the gain and loss in each of the alternates. Okay, so that's why we, when we use a word alternate, okay, for example, in design, we always say come out with two or three alternate ideas. Okay, so normally what we do is we work out a detailed design of one concept, and we make very sketchy output of the other two alternates. Okay, actually speaking, alternate means this should also work, this should also work, and this should also work the way you have aimed for the first alternate. Okay, so this should be functional. Probably this may not be economical. Okay, but the alternate should also be functional. That's one point that we should remember here as well. Okay, so the alternate should be a workable alternate. Okay, so that needs to be kept in mind. Okay. Select one of the mathematical decision theory model to apply for making a scientific decision. There are so many methods. For example, we'll be discussing so many statistical tool that can help us in decision making. Okay, so any one of the method can be, one of the tool can be applied for making a decision. Okay, so then you apply that model or a tool for making decision. Okay, so selecting one is also important, and applying that is the second step. So what is the difference between 5 and 6? 5 is we have let us say we were discussing about data sets, right? One data, we said nominal data, and we said ordinal data. Okay, and statistical tool, we have so many, 1, 2, 5 statistical tool that we have, let us say standard deviation, variance, or to let's say the even the there are certain specific statistical application that is applied for that is applicable for decision trees there. For example, maximum gain or maximini. So many, I'll be discussing that in a while. We have to carefully select any one of the two, okay, based on the data set that we have, okay, so that the tool is correct and we will get a meaningful output, okay, from the tool. Okay, so that's one thing that we should keep in mind when we say selecting a model. Applying it is, of course, apply and generate the result. Okay, so if we take the step from the lens of a let us discuss this these steps from a lens of a problem. Okay, for example, a company is considering expanding the manufacturing and marketing of a new product in a backyard of a store shed. Okay, so that's the problem that is discussed or that is described. Okay, so we have one company which wants which is intending to expand its business, okay, by manufacturing and marketing a new product. Okay, and they already have one land, and they are doing some other activity, but now they want to expand the business. Okay, so what are the alternates they have? Okay, for example, let us say construct a large new plant. Okay, construct a small new plant. Do not develop a new plant, but buy and sell. Okay, that can also be an option. So or if you see this in a typical theoretical approach, the manufacturing can be done in a large scale, or the manufacturing can be done in a smaller scale, or no manufacturing can be done, or no action is taken, no progress or nil progress is done. That means we don't do anything, so we don't get profit, or we don't get loss, or we don't take any risk. Okay, so the other alternate is going out with a small plant and then checking and then later on expanding, or you build a big plant and then start the business and then let's see how things will fall in place. Okay, so identify the third step that we have mentioned was identify possible outcome. The market could be favorable or it can be unfavorable. Okay, very simple logic. So in both the cases, how the outcome will be performed. List the payoff. Okay, the fourth step that was mentioned. Identify conditional values for profits for large plant or small plant, and no development for the two possible market conditions. Okay, so what we need to do is let us assume if we are establishing a large plant, what will be the cost involved and what is the risk involved in it, that needs to be mentioned. And when it comes to the small plant as well, the same thing needs to be mentioned. Okay, so the fourth step. We said fifth step, select a model. Okay, this depends on the environment and the amount of risk and uncertainty, and also I was telling what kind of a tool that can be used, what kind of a statistical model can be applied. Okay, it depends on other factors as well. Okay, sixth step, apply this model to the data and take a decision. Okay, so let us quickly summarize this. Clearly define the problem, generate alternates. Okay, identify possible outcomes, list the payoff. Okay, and select a statistical model, apply and take a decision. So this is what has been said here. Define the problem, list what is the alternate for that task, identify possible outcome, okay, and list the payoff, okay, and select any statistical tool and make decision. So if I have put one theoretical output, okay, not output, example that we have discussed. For example, this is the first case. Okay, there is a decision table with conditional values. For example, let us say for constructing a large plant. Okay, let's say these are just indicative numbers. Okay, don't ask me can we build something in 2 lakh. Okay, this is just for discussion. Okay, so construct a large plant. Maybe in favorable conditions we may get this much in return, or we may, if we are constructing a small plant which requires an investment of 100,000, okay, and do nothing, there is no risk involved. Okay, so if you this is in a favorable condition. Okay, so where we assume that we are going for a construction, and we aim to establish this business, and probably, okay, what is the initial cost involved in this? We may have to invest some X money in these cases. The same thing we have spent in construction of, okay, we have spent, let's say, 200,000 in a large plant. Okay, but in some unexpected market conditions, let us assume that there's a huge loss. Okay, let's say more than 80% of the money may be may get lost as well, okay, because the return is very less. Okay, it can be on the this can also apply in the case of small plant as well. Okay, so there is some investment, okay, in favorable condition probably we will get returns out of it. Okay, in unfavorable conditions when the market is down and when the, let's say like we are currently facing, okay, there's a crunch of money, okay, there's not much circulation of money, okay, there's always a fear of economic crisis, okay, so there the expenditure is less, and as a result probably this is an unfavorable market condition for investment. Okay, so this is one way it can happen. Okay, so if this is the case, okay, so how do we take decisions? If this is the B, this is like a prelim to investment, so how do we take decisions based on this? Okay, should we go for large construction or should we go for small plant for making products, or we keep quiet and wait for some more time and do not take any risk where there is no loss or gain? Okay, so if you see from theoretical perspective, there are three types of decisions that we need to understand before we proceed further. Okay, so type one, decision making under certainty. Okay, the decision makers know with certainty that consequences of every alternatives are decision choice. The second type, decision making under uncertainty, the decision makers does not know the possibility of various outcome. The third type, decision making under risk, the decision makers know the probability and various outcome. Okay, three decisions are discussed here. Okay, one where decision maker knows for certain what is the consequences of going ahead with this decision. Okay, in second condition, the decision maker does not know what will happen. Okay, is unaware of what will be the outcome. The third one is he is aware of the outcome and he wants to take a risk. Okay, these are the three things that is possible under this condition. Okay, how do we make decision? Okay, so I was telling you there are certain tools that is associated with decision making. Okay, there are several criteria for making decision under uncertainty. For example, these are some of the tools, okay, that is used for making this decision under uncertainty. Okay, where we are not certain whether the outcome will be profitable for us or not. Okay, so what are the tools, statistical tool that we have in hand? One is called Maximax. It's called optimistic decision making. There's something called Maximin, where it is called, which is pessimistic decision making, and there is something called criteria of realism, where it is actually a weighted average of maximum and minimum. I'll show you with example how do we understand this. And there is something called equally likely, and there's something called mini maximum max regret. What are these things? We'll understand these keywords from the same example. Okay, in case of Maximax, okay, so we have based on our initial defining problem and also defining the second step, that is alternate, we said that we can construct a large plant or we can construct a small plant, or we keep quiet and do nothing where there is zero investment involved in it. Okay, So we also said in favorable condition we may get this 200,000 in a large plant, and also in a small plant it is 100,000, and in unfavorable condition we may encounter loss at this rate. Okay, so what we do in Maximax or approach is we list like this, we list all the alternates, okay, and we list what is the favorable outcome that we have, what is the favorable unfavorable conditions that we have, and we take maximum value in the row in the final column. Okay, so if we have 10, let us say like this, if we have 10 alternates, okay, so we identify where we will have maximum benefit. Okay, so in this case we may get the best outcome if of 200,000 if we make a large construction for manufacturing some X product. Okay, so here we the unfavorable condition is neglected. We take what is the maximum benefit that we may encounter. Okay, that's why it is called optimistic model, where we say that Maximax. The Maximax is the keyword. It is an optimistic decision making. We assume that we will definitely have a favorable condition, and accordingly the decision is made. Okay, so here we are discussing this with a small problem, that is to construct a plant or not for manufacturing a product. So if we have n number of alternates, for all n number of alternates we need to work out in favorable market condition what will be the profit, and in unfavorable market condition what will happen to our investment. Okay, so the maximum profit that we will take is chosen. Okay, suppose let us assume that this is another zero. Okay, so in this case we will take this. Yeah, so wherever we get maximum output, okay, that alternate is chosen for further processing. Okay, so this is called Maximax, where which is also called the optimistic approach, decision approach. Okay, the second approach, this quite opposite of what we discussed now, it's Maximin, where it is a pessimistic approach. Okay, so here we consider what is the least what is the least risk, or what is the least loss that we can encounter as a result of it, of this alternate. Okay, same approach is taken like we have discussed here, but we go for the least or the minimum value that we see in the last column. Okay, so here in the first case favorable market condition is preferred. Okay, and the decision is based on this favorable market condition. In the second case, unfavorable market condition is the major criteria. Based on that, these values are arrived. Okay, so obviously if you don't do anything, there is no investment, there is no risk, and there is no loss. Okay, so if that is one of the alternate that is listed here, and obviously that will be the approach that can also, there is also one approach that can be taken. It's not necessary that always we have to be optimistic. Okay, so based on market conditions and so on and so forth, we should sometimes pessimistic approach is also taken. Okay, this is called a pessimistic approach, where we are not ready to invest, we are not ready to take any risk in this regard. And that's not a bad approach. This is also one of the acceptable decision making tool that we have theoretically. Okay, the third one is weighted average. Okay, so it is also called criterion of realism. There is a small formula adapted, okay, to get a weighted output in the in the last column, where the both okay favorable and unfavorable conditions are considered. Okay, what we have seen in the optimistic condition is only favorable market is considered. In the pessimistic condition, unfavorable market was considered. Here in this case, what we do is we take both, okay, and we do an weighted average of both the things, but at a cost. Okay, we assume that our assumption is 80% right, okay, and then we do weighted average based on this 80% value. Okay, so this can be based on the our estimation, the decision, this value can be changed. Let's say we are 60% confident, then the value will be 0.6, and then accordingly this needs to be worked out. So this is at 80%. I'm sure that I'm not sure 100% sure. In the optimistic case, I'm 100% risk is taken. Okay, so here let us assume that we take, okay, I'm sure based on my assessment 80% probably the output will be favorable. Okay, so how do you do? There is a very simple formula that is incorporated. Weighted average is equal to the assumed, okay, percentage. In this case 80, I have given one example here. Okay, maximum in row plus 1 minus the assumed percentage of assumption multiplied by minimum in the row. Okay, so how do you do that? For example, in the first case, for large plant alternate, okay, at 80% probability, 0.8 multiplied by maximum in row, this is 200,000 is the maximum in row, plus 1 minus 0.8 multiplied by minimum in the row. We are dealing one at a row. Okay, so this is for the large plant. Okay, how weighted average is calculated. For small plant, similar approach is adapted. Okay, 80% of the highest value plus, okay, 1 minus 80% 0.8 multiplied by the least value under unfavorable condition. Okay, and based on this, the highest value is taken. Okay, for an highest value or highest value the associated alternate in the highest value is considered for further processing. All right, so so weighted average also can be used. Okay, so this is slightly revised version for optimistic approach, where we say that, okay, I'm confident that the decision is I'm confident that my understanding on this market is will be 80% right or 60% right, okay, or 70% right. Okay, so based on that, the 70% is applied. 70% of the 70% assumption is applied to favorable and unfavorable condition, and then a value is arrived for taking decision. Okay, again the highest value is taken because this is a optimistic weighted average approach. Okay, this is the third way it can be done. A fourth one is called equally likely condition, where average is taken for both favorable and unfavorable condition. How do you do that? Okay, the same case, we said probably we may get a return of 200,000, and or we may lose 180,000. Okay, so in small plan probably we may get 100,000 or we may lose 20,000. Okay, so what do? We take, we add this and divide it by 2. Okay, the average of the row is taken, and then accordingly one of the decision is taken. For example, let us say in this weighted average the highest value is taken. Okay, in the equally likely case, this is kind of a pessimistic equally likely case. Okay, so optimistic equally likely case where the highest value is taken again here. Okay, like we do in the weighted average case as well. Okay, so whatever highest value based on the alternates, for each alternate we work out the average. Okay, average between what is the during the favorable condition, during unfavorable condition, and then wherever we get the maximum profit, okay, that alternate is chosen for further processing. Okay, last one is minimax regret, where maximum in row. Okay, for example, let us say in unfavorable condition we will lose 180,000. Okay, so in this case, let us say this is do nothing, we will remain, we will have that 200,000 with us. Okay, and in unfavorable condition for a large plan we may lose 180,000. Okay, but if we do a small plant, okay, the investment will be 100,000 only. Okay, so mini max. Okay, so in the last tool, in the last parameter or statistical tool, where mini max regret, not the highest value, not the lowest value, it is a kind of a risk. Okay, I'm not very sure to go for a full fledged plant, or I don't want to keep quiet as well. Okay, so what do we do is we take a balanced approach. Okay, let me if I invest in the large plant, probably I may end up losing this much money. Okay, and if I don't do, of course I retain this, but I don't want to keep quiet as well. I want to try something. Okay, so I want to take that risk. So in that case, okay, this minimum value is arrived. Okay, so it is a minimum max regret. That means in unfavorable condition, even if I lose, I'll lose the least value. Okay, least value from the alternate that we have. Okay, so there are five criteria for decision making under uncertainty. One is maximax, this optimistic approach, okay, where favorable market is considered. In the second case, the unfavorable market is considered. Third case, okay, weighted average of both favorable and unfavorable condition, and a percentage assumption is made. Okay, 80 whatever decision I'm taking is 80% valid or 70% valid, and so on and so forth. Okay, and equally likely case, okay, we take an average of this, and then we take the highest value in this case as well. In the last case, we take the least, what will be the least loss that we may encounter as a result of this decision. Okay, so these are some of the techniques available for arriving at a decision. Okay, based on this. Okay, I think Okay, maybe we will discuss this little later. I will stop this here. Okay, so we will continue our discussion on decision tree and how do we construct decision tree, all that little later. Okay, so if you have any questions, you can ask me. Otherwise, we'll close it for the day.